Merry meet my lovely ones. This is Del from Violet Cottage. Thank you kindly for sharing a moment in your day with me. Just thought I'd update you on what I've been doing, some of the projects I've been working on. This is a long-standing project that's been going on for 2 months now. And that's the decorative gate and archway. And to frame all of this, I thought I'd create a bit of a decorative fence around it. Using old bike wheels, upcycled bike wheels that I found and salvaged for free from the tip. So this is what I've been working on and I have now finished. So later on today I'll be starting to affix them to the fence, which will hopefully frame the decorative arch and the decorative gate that I've made. I mean, I thought I'd tell you about some of the materials I used. So with this one, you can obviously see I've used horseshoes and the silver bit, just wait for the trucks to go past, of course. The brass bit in the middle is actually a bed knock off, an old cast iron brass bed head, and horseshoes, obviously, that I've spray painted a brassy sort of antique brass colour. And I've used the blue swirls, the coily bits, they're actually from an old mattress, an old rusted mattress, and I've just spray painted them blue and affixed a bead to finish it off. And then we move across to the biggest ones. I kept them not too ornamental because we don't want to detract away from the decorations of the fence, but as I said in one other video, I think, or maybe a Facebook post, the brass leaves, goldy brass leaves, are actually old candy dishes that I bought in bulk. Now, I bought these from an online auction, actually, and they belong to a restaurant. They're upside down, and they used to have a little glass dish in them for candies, cashews, nuts, that sort of thing. And when I bought them, it was just for the bases. The glass top had obviously either, I don't know, been sold separately somewhere else, or maybe they were damaged, I don't know. But I ended up getting a large stock lot of these candy dishes, so I've used them for decorative leaves, or petals in this case. But they could also be, I think, used for pate molds or jelly molds or something like that. That's pretty cool. The center of the flower here is yet again another sort of brass decal off an old brass cast iron bedhead frame. So I've used that just for the centerpiece. So these are things that I just collect, little knickknacks that can be turned into decorative items later on. Let me move on to some of the other ones. These are some of the other ones that I've used. These are the smallest ones, and I've just wired on some beadwork, and the little gold brass flowers were actually part of those candy dishes that I was just talking about before that I bought in bulk. And so I've sort of utilized every little piece of those candy dishwares and repurposed it for that. Yet again, I've used more of the blue bedhead coils, or bed coils, I should say, that were from an old antique inner spring mattress thing. And I've just spray painted them. Then I've just used wire, thin wire, gauge wire, to weave the beads onto the spokes of the bike wheels. And I thought I'd make some sort of flashy style and little bits with just wire bead work. So that is all of them. And later on, I'm going to be wiring them onto my fence. And I should hopefully show you soon enough the finished product of all of these. But I've had fun making them, but I absolutely love bike wheels because they can be used for all sorts of applications, repurposed applications. They can actually be used in the garden bed, which I'm planning to do actually in our veggie garden. I'm hoping to make a wall of just plain bike wheels so that climbing plants can grow up. They can be made for all sorts of things. So you can leave them either just plain and use them as fencing, or for growing plants on. Or you can decorate them by spray painting them and adding some decorative details to them, like I have. Okay, just thought I'd keep a quick one for this one. And then I'll get on with actually wiring them to the fence, which I'm really looking forward to. Okay, thank you once again for joining me here at Violet Cottage, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.